The Three Sisters is a model for community organizing.
In our communities, you need people that can stand tall, like the corn, and they need people to assist and hold them up, like the beans. And then you have your squash that's laying down to protect everything. It's something that's opening our eyes to see what our ancestors was trying to show us.
The Haudenosaunee adopt the Three Sisters cooperative approach in nature to a cooperative approach in governance. This principle is expressed in the structure that defines their very identity, the longhouse. Pete Jemison is an elder from the Seneca people.
The Haudenosaunee, what that translates to is that our people built an extended house. And when we're talking about this house that they built, it's not just the longhouse that we actually live in. It is the idea that each of the nations take up the issues that are confronting the community, and they try to come up with solutions.
Leaders from the warring tribes come together in a longhouse and form the Grand Council of Chiefs. It is America's first democratic legislature. Inspired by Hiawatha and the Peacemaker, the council votes to end war among their nations.
He was a sorcerer. He had supernatural powers. He could communicate with the birds and rattlesnakes and wolves and the animal world, and they would help him. He was a mean, mean man. His name was Tarudahu.
To convince Tarudahu to join the new confederacy, Hiawatha and the Peacemaker seek a powerful ally. A woman named Jigonsase.
Jigonsase was the first clan mother. She helped bring peace to the Iroquois, to the Haudenosaunee.
Virginia Abrams is a clan mother, a title first established by Jigonsase. Like Palenque's King Pakal, Jigonsase's influence comes from corn.
When the nations were warring against each other, she would take them in and feed them. And she kind of kept the war going on. So the peacemaker came to her and asked her to refrain from keeping this warring going on between our people.
Jigonsase's stockpile of corn perpetuates the bloodshed by feeding the warriors. The peacemaker strikes a deal with her. If she can stop the war, she can choose the chiefs. Jigonsase transforms Tarudahu's mind, and he abandons war. Because of Jigonsase, clan mothers hold the power to appoint or dismiss chiefs.
She earned for our women the rights, the responsibilities, and the privileges that they have until this date.
And Tododaho, in exchange for accepting peace, is appointed the keeper of the central fire and chief of chiefs, the most powerful leader. His name becomes a title that is handed down to this day.
When our longhouses come together, these are the fires he's talking about.
Sid Hill is now Tododaho. He sees an important lesson in memorializing the name of this once vicious warlord.
People can change with help if they're going on the wrong path. There is always hopes to people helping them and showing them there's better things you can do with your life than being destructive and evil and negative.
With the final obstacle overcome, the peacemaker assembles representatives of each nation. From the time of the peacemaker to today, the tradition of making wampum belts lives on. A new generation is being entrusted with the story of democracy encoded in the Hiawatha Belt.
Your thoughts and energy, that's the strength of that belt. One day you're gonna get old, and then you're the one that's gonna have to transmit all this knowledge, what it means, to your grandkids.
At the beginning of the Confederacy, the peacemaker made the symbol. It's our connection to each other. When I hold this Hiawatha Belt, what it means to me is that we're a united nation.
Under a total eclipse of the sun, the peacemaker holds the newly woven Hiawatha Belt, and with the nations gathered beneath the Tree of Peace, he speaks the law of peace for the first time. The reading of the Great Law and the weaving of the Hiawatha Belt established the Haudenosaunee Confederacy. It's a form of government that doesn't rule people, but rather serves people. It's this principle that inspires Benjamin Franklin and other framers of the Constitution to create their own government of the people, by the people, and for the people. In 1988, the U.S. Senate passed a special resolution recognizing the influence of the Haudenosaunee democracy on the U.S. Constitution. The Council of Chiefs meeting in the Longhouse is similar to Congress. Tododaho parallels the presidency. And the clan mothers are like justices on the Supreme Court. They too serve for life, but have an additional power. Clan mothers can choose and impeach the chiefs. It is a three-branch system of government that looks strikingly familiar. Six 600 years before the United States, the Haudenosaunee independently established the first democracy in America.
Hi.
Today, the Haudenosaunee gather on the shore of Lake Onondaga, the place where their journey from war to peace began.
All these leaders could work together to come up with a solution.
They build their confederacy based on profound lessons and symbols from nature.
Mother Earth never lacked nothing. They had a perfect world.
But like a treaty between nations, they believe they owe nature something in return. To take care of all living things.
Water and air and all the natural things that make the world that we live in is held sacred by all indigenous people. And every human being comes from an indigenous people.
This ceremony is an appeal to honor that responsibility to nature. For Onondaga Lake, the birthplace of democracy in America, is among the world's most polluted.
Everybody's concerned these days about the condition of the waters, the condition of Mother Earth. It's a concern throughout the world. That was put there for everybody to use, and nobody has the right to take that away from anybody.
It's not just the water. It's not just made out of chemical elements. It's real. It's our lifeblood.
Over 200 years ago, the framers of the U.S. Constitution learned lessons of governance from the Haudenosaunee. But the founding fathers leave out a core principle. People have a responsibility to take care of the earth. Native America's profound respect for nature is relevant now as much as ever.
Creator, we who are your children says thank you for this miraculous gathering and this beautiful day that you gave us today. Creator, with love, we say thank you, and our mind is agreed.
The First Nations of the Americas have their foundation in sacred natural symbols. In Chavin, priests use the jaguar to gather people into a nation. In Central America, corn builds vast kingdoms. In the Atlantic Northeast, shell wampum unites nations. And in the Pacific Northwest, cedar establishes and maintains a national identity. Building on lessons from nature, Native Americans create some of the greatest nations on Earth.